Hi everyone, so in this video we will try to understand our Hello World component first. Okay, so I mean since the last video we are hearing a lot of new different terms, so first of all list them down and we will try to understand one by one. NPM, second is we heard about JSX, okay, third is we heard about Babel, or you can say Webpack. And fourth is we know the React and React DOM, which are simple one. Okay, these are the few different terms which we just talked about. Okay, NPM we already have installed, so we can mark this as a done. Now we have the Node and NPM available locally. Okay, we are able to install the React package and React DOM package using NPM install --- save React and React DOM. JSX we talked about, this is some kind of HTML XML like syntax which we are writing to create a component. Okay, to create a component we are writing this kind of a mixture inside a JavaScript. Okay, and we are also wrapping it inside a JavaScript. Okay, now there will be a challenge. Okay, how our browser will understand this, right? So React will take a responsibility of managing this HTML XML like syntax inside a JavaScript. Okay, we have to convert this code into either purely JS JavaScript only so that browser can read it and we can see output on UI. This is how this is going to be, right? Now Babel and Webpack, this is a different category, and these are two different things, Babel and Webpack. Webpack is actually a module loader and Babel is a transpiler. In most of the learning sessions, you will not hear about them because you are directly moving to the path of Create React App. If you started learning React from Create React App, then most probably you have missed a lot of things in background, right? Because we just need to think, okay, we have only React and React DOM as a NPM package. What else we need to write a component? So Babel and Webpack is that thing which you need if you are not using Create React App, because I'm going to cover React without Create React App and with Create React App. So in that case, you need Babel and Webpack. So you need to understand these terms also, what Babel is doing, what Webpack is doing. Okay. So Webpack is doing nothing, but in simple terms, it is actually bundling your all JavaScript files into single bundle.js. bundle.js, and it is giving you so that inside your index.html you can add a script tag, pass the bundle.js, and it will show the component on the UI. What Babel is doing is a little interesting. So Babel is actually a transpiler. So here in the slide, if we talk about Node and NPM is done, ES6 obviously we will be writing the classes, all the concepts of ES6. Here we are talking about these two things, loaders and transpilers. So the first thing we are talking about is Webpack. Webpack is totally a separate topic which can take n number of videos to cover, but here I'm talking about this Webpack is a module loader which is bundling, managing all the dependencies. I need React, I need React DOM, I need some other npm package. So it is managing those dependencies and it is giving me the final bundle.js file. Another thing is transpilers, what it is. So we talked about Babel. Babel is acting as a transpiler. So we already seen the component. What we are writing is HTML with JavaScript, right? Which browser has no idea what to do with. So in that case, that Babel, this component will be feed into Babel, which will convert this whole code into single JavaScript file. It will do something with this HTML code and it will give you simple .js file where everything is JavaScript, no HTML, no JSX, everything is JavaScript, and then it will feed it to the browser. If you already know Babel Webpack, you can skip this. There is already a separate playlist about Webpack and Babel on my YouTube channel. If you wanted to have a look, you can take a look. But when we go to the Create React App path, you don't need to learn it. You don't need to understand it because there you are, it is giving you the platform to write directly a component and compile it and see that on the UI. Okay, so there are two things. Webpack is a module bundler, bundling all the dependencies, Babel is a transpiler which is transpiling your code to ES5. Now, first of all, what we are doing is we are writing ES6. We are writing ES6 code. Our browser can't understand it. You are writing JSX. That also our browser can't understand it, right? So these two things are being handled by Babel to convert into ES5. Correct. What is ES5? ECMAScript 5, which currently the browsers are running. We have ES6, 7, 8. But how we are able to run those apps on our browser? Because we are using Babel as a transpiler. Babel has a capability which is helping you to write code in ES7, ES8, and then compiling it back to the ES5 as an output bundle so that your browser can run that application with all the features you have used from ES7, ES8, ES10. Right? Magic. Because browsers will take time to adopt that functionalities of latest JavaScript features. Meanwhile, you can keep using Babel and React, create React app, Angular CLI, Vue CLI, you name the tool, everything is using Babel to help you to write the latest features and compile it back to the lower versions of JavaScript so browser can read it. Okay, so here we are writing, and third thing is obviously the React component. That is simple, it is already a kind of JavaScript code, like you are writing classes and all. So it is ES6, we are already compiling it with the Babel. So we are giving ES5 output to the browser, and browser is happily able to read it and show you the output on the UI. We will see how that output look like, okay, in the next video.